When someone Googles a business like yours in their city, what do they see? You have probably seen it multiple times. Apart from the regular search results, there are additional features for local business. The local pack as a group of three businesses together with a map snippet, the local finder that you see when clicking on more places, and also Google Map results if you head to the map right away. But do you know how to increase your visibility there as a local business? And how to stay ahead of your competitors in these search results? In this video, we are sharing 5 essential tips and 5 advanced strategies to achieve that. So, let's dive in. To appear in local search results, you need to create a Google Business Profile, the GBP, for your business. And how well it's set up and optimized is one of the biggest success factors for local search. In fact, local marketing experts believe it might affect local search results by more than 30%, among other signals and areas. Google will show your Google Business Profile to someone in local search based in 3 factors: distance, relevance, and prominence. But there's a lot of nuance within each one of them. First of all, what does Google want from you? In their own words, Google is looking for accurate, complete, and engaging information on your Google Business Profile. You can be physically far away from the search location than other business, but if Google thinks that you are more likely to provide what a user is searching for, you will rank higher for local search. That's why your Google Business Profile is so important. It's all about getting the most relevant customers to your doorstep, whether there's a physical or a virtual storefront. Now let's make sure that your Google Business Profile is in that accurate, complete, and engaging state. To kick things off, let's quickly look at basic setup tips. Tip number 1, ensure your business name is accurate. Make sure the name field exactly matches your actual business name. Unless your business name already includes terms like clothing, repairs, or luxury watch Chicago, don't try to add those keywords here. If you do, you are giving your competitors a reason to report you to Google, and you are giving Google a reason to suspend your profile. This works, of course, on the other way around. If you see your competitors adding keywords to their business names on Google, feel free to use that against them as well. Tip number 2, select the right categories. Be intentional when selecting your categories, meaning take the time to choose the right primary and secondary categories, up to 10 in total, that correctly represent your business to Google. This is crucial for appearing in Google's local search features. The categories are also among the most influential factors that impact your local rankings. Finding the suitable category may be simple for certain businesses. Sometimes the most relevant ones is just obvious. But what do you do if it's not super clear? Which one is the most suitable for your business? In this case, try to rely on the most relevant search terms for the area. You can use keyword tools by Google or Semrush for that. Pro tip here, use Semrush Local's analytics tool to check out the categories of your competitors. This helps you to compare with them and find any category gaps you can take advantage of. When you are sure about your primary category, use secondary ones to complement it. But keep in mind, having random secondary categories from unrelated fields or treating secondary categories as keywords, again, it's a reason for profile suspension. Picking the right categories also opens up additional engagement opportunities for you. For example, restaurants can add menu and reservation links, and hotels can list their service. Tip number 3, keep track of NAP consistency. Keep your business name, address, and phone number always updated. What you have in your GBP should not only match your website, it should be the same all across the internet, including listings and directory. The main way to Google to ensure that accuracy is to check if you have the same information in your website code and also in your Google Business Profile. There are 2 ways to ensure that you are always up-to-date information, both with your GBP and other directories. First is manual updates, which can be time-consuming and also prone to errors. Another approach is to use list and manage tools, like the one in Semrush Local, With listing management, you can input your information once distributed across major directories, including your GPP, without the hassle of copy-pasting. And remember, be clear about your open hours. It can influence user engagement and reviews, and it has recently been considered a ranking factor when someone searches for a business that is open now. Tip number 4, verify your Google Business Profile. Another quick step for basic setup is verifying your GPP, as this also impacts your rankings in Google Local Search results. There are multiple ways to verify your Google Business Profile. A quick one is to get verification when adding your website to Google Search Console. And now, tip number 5, showcase relevant business information. Where you actually are or where you provide your services is very important for appearing in local search results. And here are no secret tactics. The main thing to remember is to include your real address if you have a storefront. Or if you are a service area business, only choose a service area. One more thing to mention is uploading relevant photos that include all things related to your business. You don't need to geotag them. Apart from that, it's a pretty straightforward and yet important process. Now we have covered the fundamentals. What's next? Following these tips will help you to get accurate and complete information on your GPP in terms of basic setup step. What we will cover next are 5 advanced strategies that will bring even better results to your business. The first advanced strategy is to optimize your GPP description. You might have noticed that we did not mention your business description in the basic tips. But why? We did so because we want you to really pay attention on this. Having a well-crafted GPP description alone won't enhance your ranks or visibility. You don't need to cram your description with every relevant keyword you can think of. However, there are 2 aspects it contributes to: your GPP completeness and engagement. These are the factors that Google looks at when deciding where you will pop up. Google also checks your general business authority comprehensively, and your GPP description plays an important role here. So having a detailed and engaging description is important, but treat it less as a SEO piece and more as a touch point with your potential customer. Here they can learn about your expertise, trustworthiness, unique value, who you are and what you do or offer. If we treat your Google Business Profile as something that completing your website's homepage, this is a place to nail messaging, positioning, and differentiation. If you are looking for a free tool that will help you to craft your GPP description in just 30 seconds, click on the link in the description to explore Semrush Local's AI GPP Description Generator. It will not only create an SEO-optimized business description, but it will also provide you with 10 niche keywords, Q&A ideas, and a social media post suggestion. Our second advanced strategy is take care of your reviews. On the surface, it seems very simple. Get as many great reviews as you can, right? But there are some details to take into account. First of all, it's true that pure numbers matter. The number of reviews with text and your average rating impact how you are positioned compared to your competitors. But there are other factors. First, how old or recent the reviews are. Businesses with more recent, detailed reviews on their GPP tend to rank higher. So keeping your reviews up to date can give you an advantage over your competitors. And the second point, the frequency with which your reviews are coming. It's important that you get a steady flow of reviews over time, instead of getting tens of reviews in 1 week and then no new ones for a month. Third point, keyword that people mention in their reviews matter too. If you look for a brunch place on Google Maps, some business might pop up based on brunch being mentioned by their customers. Google is also taking into account the general feeling positive or negative in your reviews. It's also known that responding to reviews in timely and non-templated manner is taken into consideration. So, to having positive reviews not only on your GPP, but on other platforms and review websites. By the end, what are we getting at here? You should treat generating and managing reviews for your business as an ongoing practice. And by the way, all of that can become much easier with Semrush Local Reviews Management. You can manage your reviews, use AI to craft responses, and even set auto replies. Be sure to check out the links in the description for more details. Now, our advanced strategy number 3, Google Business Posts and Socials. This is a feature that lets you have a sort of a separated company blog inside your Google Business profile, and it's often overlooked by business. But how often should you post? How does it affect your local search results? Let's try to bring as much clarity as we can together with some tips. Going back to the very beginning, Google wants you accurate, complete, and engaging information from your GPP. A lot of the tips you have covered so far are about accuracy and completeness. Well, GPP posts are all about engagement. How you appear in search might change. Sometimes posts are visible from the search results page that increase the number of people clicking on your Google Business profile to learn more about it. Also, the time people spend in your Google Business profile can increase. With posts, they don't just check a couple of photos and read your description. They have a full feed of content to explore. And do you know what that means by the end? When users explore your Google Business profile, it tells Google that your business is interesting, engaging, and worth showing to more users in the area. Finally, it's your opportunity to show content to potential customers, right at the moment when they are looking for your products or service. And you don't need to spend a dime on getting that content in front of them. Imagine you see a complete Google Business profile for a service you are looking for. It has great reviews, they provide service in the area you are looking for, and on top of that, you also find ratings, happy customers, or engaging content in their Google posts. When everything else is on par among multiple businesses, this section can make the difference. So seize the opportunity and stand out. Needless to say, Semrush Local can also help you to create Google Business profile posts with AI, and schedule them for months in advance using our GPP posting feature. It's also linked in the video description. Another feature Google recently added is the ability to include social media links in your GPP. This helps you to drive traffic beyond just your GPP. And these links, along with the posts, contribute to your overall engagement. This option is not available in all regions yet, but it's a great chance to help potential customers to connect with you. Additionally, linking your social media to your GPP can help Google find social signals. These signals show how users engage with your business, and of course, it helps with local ranks too. Advanced strategy number 4, products and services. Another GPP area that is important is adding products or services. There are mixed opinions about just adding a list of services or products to your GPP. But here's what's worked for sure. Using them to complement the added products or service from your website. Also, when you have products or service added, Google can highlight it for search. You can see the special highlight when business provides a specific service or has a product in stock when searching for something specific near you. So don't skip this section together with adding our service products to your website. And finally, advanced strategy number 5, go beyond Google Business Profile. We have covered a lot already, but there's our final tip, and it's probably the most important one. Your work doesn't end with creating an accurate, complete, and engaging Google Business profile. First of all, accuracy, completeness, and engagement should be monitored and optimized all the time. This is the only way to stay ahead and keep eager customers walking through your door. One effective way to stay ahead is leveraging the Semrush Local tools. They can help you to track your GPP performance and gather insights for optimization. It will help you to get a very detailed view on your ranks on a map and gather insights on competitors with Map Ranking Tracker. As we mentioned before, your Google Business Profile plays a key role on local search performance. But don't forget about your website, internal links, and backlinks from trusted local sites. Once you have implemented all the Google Business Profile tips and strategy, it's smart to explore these other factors for even better results. And fortunately, there are always tools that can take those boring manual tasks off your hands to keep everything running smoothly, both for your Google Business Profile and your other online visibility efforts. Check out the tools listed in the description below. I see you on top, and I hope to find you on the map. Take care.